There is one very critical pitfall which will cause global scripts to run when they're not supposed to. This can definitely cause issues with your SCADA application. They are very hard to troubleshoot. I can pretty much guarantee you that you've had issues associated with what I'm about to show you, and you probably didn't even know what it is. So in this video, I am going to show you exactly what causes global actions to run when they're not supposed to, and what you can do to fix the problem. Global actions, which can be either C or VBS, are scripts that run independent of your runtime user interface, your screens. Instead, they run in the background. They're executed when a tag changes value or on a time cycle or on both. So here I have an action that basically just grabs the time and it prints out that it's running in response to this tag changing value, and it prints out the value. If we right click and look at our trigger, we can see when this is set to run. Basically, we have a tag here, and I can have any number of tags here. When any of them change value, it will run this script. Or of course, we could add a timer on this. I'll just save this. And then in runtime, I am also going to pull up my AP diag. And so this is a button here. When I toggle it, it changes the tag. The tag executes the script and it just says, hey, this is only going to run when this tag changes value. I could actually just go right in here and change it manually and it's going to run. And you can see I've got a couple other time-based global actions. Going back to C, I have a 1 minute action and it just prints out the time again. It says it's the 1 minute C action. If we go look at the trigger here, you can see it is set to 1 minute, and we could change this to, you know, different cycles that we want. And so the idea here is we have a script that's going to run based on time. So I have an hourly action and it does the same thing. I just want to show you what the triggers look like. I can set this hourly to also run at a specified minute and second in each hour. So I just did 0 and 0 here. We also have a 5 minute trigger and a daily. So this runs once per day. So if we look at the timer, I've just set it to run on midnight, and that's when this is going to run. Now, if we open up our VBS editor, I have pretty much the same thing. I have a tag triggered action that only executes when this VBS action trigger executes. If I want to look at the trigger, it's pretty much the same thing as you might expect. So again, going into runtime and pulling up my AP diag, I'll just clear this out. So you can see my tag triggers run only when the tags change. It doesn't matter what changes them. If the PLC changes them or if the operator changes them, they're going to run. And as far as our time-based, we're going to wait. And here's the VBS 1 minute. And so there you can see our VBS 5 minute global action just hit, and then there's my 1 minute C action. You might think that we have a really solid handle on exactly when these are going to run. However, there is one very critical pitfall which will cause global scripts to run when they're not supposed to. In this video, I am going to show you exactly what causes global actions to run when they're not supposed to, and what you can do to fix the problem. So first, let's take a look at what the problem is. I'm going to clear my output window. I'm going to pull up my C editor. This is the daily global script, and I'm going to right click and compile this and watch this window. I'm going to hit save. And when I compile and save this, it ran the 5 minute global action. It ran the 1 minute global action, and it also ran my tag triggered action, and my tag did not change. So let's try another one. If I open up my tag triggered, this is my C action for my trigger tag. I'll clear this just so we're not confused. I'll hit compile. I'll hit save. Here again, it ran my 1 minute action, my 5 minute action, my tag triggered action. If I open my hourly, hit compile, clear this, and hit save, it does the same thing. And if we open up our VBS editor, I'll do the same thing. This is my tag triggered action, and I don't have to compile. I can just hit save and take a look. It ran my 5 minute, my 1 minute, my 10 minute, and my tag triggered action. If I open up my hourly action, hit save, it does the same thing. The problem also happens if you're adding a brand new action. I'll just grab an action here and I'll just paste in some of my code. This is the new VBS action. And then we will put a trigger on this. So I'll go to trigger. I'll just add a time cycle. Let's say this runs every 10 minutes. I can just give it whatever name that I want, hit apply and okay. And I'll bring up AP diag and clear this. And then as soon as I save this, It runs. It runs the action I just made, the 10-minute, the 1-minute, the 5-minute, and my tag trigger. So to sum up the problem, when I compile and save a C or a VBS action, it will rerun any of my tag trigger actions, whether or not the tags have changed. It will also rerun any time cycle under an hour. Now let's consider why we use actions. Let's say that you are inserting a production report into a database every time a part finishes, and we know when that part finishes because it flips a bit in the PLC and then it triggers an action, then you're going to see extra production records in your database and you don't know why. That's the biggest problem of all, is you have no idea where all these glitches are coming from, and you can spend a lot of time and hours trying to troubleshoot this. Well, the good news is now you know about the problem. Let's talk about how to solve it. The best solution is to simply use any relevant tags in an action to decide whether or not to run the code based on their value. And so let's take the example of this binary tag here. If we go out and look at our trigger, it's just using this binary tag and we're reading it. So I am just going to grab this. And let's say that we refactor this to only run when the tag changes 0 to 1. So the 0 to 1 transition. So we'll just say if our tag read equals 1, then, and then we'll do an else statement, which this is going to be the tag is 1 going to 0 transition. We're not going to do anything, so I won't even put any code here. I'll just put a comment, do nothing. Then I'll do my end if. So if we look at this, when this tag is triggered, first it's going to check if the tag is a 1. If it is, it's going to run code. If it's not, it does nothing. Now the last thing that we need to do is we are going to set this to 0 to let the code know that we have run the code. So we will just do dot write 0. And here we're resetting the tag so that we know it's run. It's important for you to know that when you run this line of code, you're changing the value of this tag, it is going to rerun this script. But now it's going to rerun it with a 0, and it's going to compare it to 1. It's not going to compare to 1. It's going to come here. It's not going to do anything. How this solves the problem is when it arbitrarily triggers when you save it, the tag is presumably going to be a 0, and it's not just going to run. So what I'll do is I will just save this, and then we will go back to runtime and pull this up. I will clear this out. And right now our tag is a 0. We'll change it to 1. It went to 0 going to 1. It executed. And then you can see it set it back to 0. Now, if I go back to my VBS editor, and I'll just clear this, if I just save this, notice it did run all my time cycles because we haven't done anything to them, but it did not run my tag triggered one. And we could also do this in the C action, and I'll just minimize this. We'll go into our C action trigger. And we're basically going to do the same thing. I'll just put an if statement here, and we will go get our tag value, and we will check if it's equal to 1. And I am just going to go grab the name of my tag and put it in here. So this is going to check it, and we want to set this to a 0 to reset the tag. So we're going to use set tag bit. And then we'll just put an else statement back here. And I'll just put some curly braces just to make sure we're doing the right code conventions here. And then for our else, we're not going to do anything. And then I will compile and save. And then we will go back to runtime and we will test that the C action is working correctly. So right now we are a 0. I will toggle this. It'll go to 1. It'll run the C action. It set itself back to 0. And then we will pull up our C actions here. And I will just right click, compile this, save it. It did run my minute based ones, but it did not run my tag trigger. So that's how you fix a script where you're using some tags. Now let's take a look at what not to do when you're using a binary trigger. Here I have an action. It is using the same trigger tag as before, the C action trigger. But here we've written it. So we grab the tag value and store it in a variable tag value. And if it is a 1, then we run this line of code. If it is a 0, we run this code. Well, the problem with that is it's a binary tag. It's always going to be either 0 or 1. So I'm just going to save this. And if we go to runtime, I'll pull up AP Diag, it's zero. So I changed it to a one, it's running the value equals one code. Now I toggle it again, now it's running the one going to zero code. But no matter which state that tag is in, if I go and I compile and save this, it's always going to run it because the tag is always going to meet one of these conditions. So if you can help it, don't write code where you're executing code for either condition of the tag to prevent this problem. We can prevent code from running in time-based scripts using a similar method. Here I've created an internal tag called compile flag, and it's a binary type. And the idea is we are going to set this to one before compiling and saving actions to prevent them from running, and then we can set it back to a zero. So going back to our VBS scripts, I've added a couple of lines of code. First, I go and get the value, and you want to get it synchronously. That's what this call to one means, and it will wait to actually read the tag before it executes the next line. This is necessary in VBS because sometimes it won't read the tag in time. And then we check the compile flag, and if it is a zero, then we run whatever code we want to run when the action fires. And then if it is a one, then I'm just going to print something out to let me know that it did work. It detected that it was a one, and we just print out that we didn't run the code. So I've put this on all of my actions in VBS and also in C. Here I've set my compile flag to the value of the tag. I just check it and make sure it's not one. And if it is not one, I execute my code. If it is one, then I print out something. Now when we go to runtime, I'll open up one of my action scripts and compile and save, and you can see it detected it, but it dropped out and did not run the code. If I go to my VBS actions, it's the same thing. I can just hit save. It did not run these. Now, it's very important to remember, you've got to go back and turn this back off so that your project runs normally. So you might want to tie this tag into something prominent, letting the operator know that the tag is set and the project may not be running normally. So what I've done is I've made this conspicuous warning message. I use the info attention dark icons out of my SVG library and a static text, and I just group them. And then on this particular object to the display, I will just associate my compile tag. And so if the compile flag is high, you'll see this. And if it's not, you won't. And then we can just kind of go back to runtime. And this way we know that the compile flag is on. The operator knows to contact us if it gets left on. Okay, that's all I've got for you today. I really appreciate you hanging in there with me on this video. I really feel like it's important that you know about this. If this was helpful to you, I would really appreciate you subscribing to my channel, liking and sharing this video. And if you'd like to become a member and be able to get some of the WinCC project code that I show in these videos, then please hit the join button to learn more. Thank you for watching.